Hare Krishna. Stop trying to control how you feel. Start taking control of what you do. Our emotions, our feelings often obstruct us in our purposes. We know something is important for us to do, but we often experience feelings wholly inappropriate or incompatible with that purpose. We want to grow spiritually, but we get sensual desires, we get resentful feelings, we don't feel at all spiritually inspired. So when this happens, sometimes we start battling with the feelings. Why am I feeling like this? I shouldn't be feeling like this. However, it's very difficult to control the feelings because they just come like the weather. Just as the weather changes unpredictably beyond our capacity to control. Similarly, our emotions also change. So, if we are trying to control our emotions, we are often fighting a very difficult battle. The important thing to understand is that our emotions alone don't determine our actions. No matter how we feel, we can still act according to our principles. And that capacity to understand that emotions don't have to determine our actions, that capacity is developed by our spirituality. The Bhagavad Gita tells us in the 14th chapter that most of our feelings arise from the three modes of material nature. In 14.22 to 25, it talks about how prakasham cha pravrittim cha mohameva cha pandava. Sometimes we feel illuminated, sometimes we feel hyperactive, sometimes we feel lethargic and apathetic. These are just emotions that arise from the modes of material nature. And Krishna says, don't just be a detached observer of them. Don't get carried away by them. Don't resent them when they come. Don't crave for them when they go away. Nadveshti sam pravrittani na nivrittani kaankshati. Then what should we do? So Krishna says, don't engage with your emotions so much. What should we do then? We focus our energy on acting practically. That Krishna says in 14.26 when he says, Mamchayo vyabhicharena bhakti yogena sevate sagunan samati tyaitan brahma bhuyaya kalpate. So he says, with unflinching devotion, just engage in the practice of bhakti. If we do this, we will transcend the modes. That means unwanted emotions will become weaker and will go beyond them. Now here when Krishna is saying bhakti yogena sevate, he says engage in service. So the point Krishna is making over here is that we may not at that time feel the emotion of devotion. So if we are under the modes, then our emotions will naturally be determined or at least shaped by the modes. So we can't control the emotions. But Krishna is talking about bhakti yoga as a seva. We can still engage in doing devotional activities. So we can still, even if we don't feel like it, we can study scripture, we can chant the holy names, we can do something constructive. And as we start doing something constructive, gradually our emotions will start aligning with it. Because especially when we try to do some devotional activity, that activity connects us with Krishna. And through that connection with Krishna, purity starts percolating into our consciousness. And as purity starts percolating, then the impurity starts getting pushed out. So, thus, gradually, the hostile feelings will subside and devotional feelings, conducive feelings, compatible feelings will arise. So, instead of trying to fight to control our feelings, we can focus on taking control of what we do. The more we engage in principled actions in a mode of service to Krishna, the more we will be able to act constructively, productively, and we will also be able to purify ourselves, thus freeing ourselves from the hold of unwanted emotions. Thank you. Hare Krishna.